wszystkich bardzo, bardzo serdecznie na otwarciu w 11 już Międzynarodowej Konferencji Innowacyjność i Kreatywność w Gospodarce. Tym razem, proszę Państwa, skupiamy się na zrównoważonym projektowaniu, innowacyjnym biznesie, a tak naprawdę będzie tematyka dotyczyła kwestii związanych z recyklingiem, jak również z ponownym używaniem odzyskanych składników, komponentów, elementów, które mają służyć, proszę Państwa, ponownemu wykorzystaniu dla celów oszczędnościowych, dla celów ekologicznych i, proszę Państwa, dla realizacji gospodarki zamkniętego obiegu. Jest to bardzo ważny element, na który kładzie w tej chwili nacisk nie tylko Unia Europejska od 2012 roku, ale również od tego roku nasz rząd, ściśle biorąc, reprezentowany przez Ministerstwo Przedsiębiorczości i Technologii.
Madam President, Mr. Senator, Madam Director, Deputy Director General of WIPO, dear participants, good morning. First of all, I wish to express my sincere gratitude to the Patents Office of the Republic of Poland for inviting me to be part of the opening of this important event. It's really a great honor. I take it as an expression of the strong partnership that exists between Poland and Denmark when it comes to innovation and creativity. And let me assure you that we are ready to work with you on deepening and broadening this partnership further. And what can Denmark offer in such a partnership, you might ask? Well, first and foremost, we can offer to share our experience in innovation, creativity, and sustainable design. Denmark is in the top of the global ranking of innovative nations, and Denmark is recognized internationally as a front runner in several areas of technology and research with a global impact. Just to mention two areas, clean energy. 30 years of focused energy policy has placed Denmark at the forefront of the development and use of renewable energy, such as wind, and we aim at being fossil-free by 2050. Another area is the Danish biotechnology cluster, which is a major world player, especially in areas such as bioengineering and enzyme research, with close collaboration between universities, hospitals, and companies, and a very competitive pharma industry. Now, all this innovation in Denmark is closely related to design. There's a close connection. Excellence in creating beautiful and intuitive products has always been at the core of Danish industrial design. Companies in the industry have used industrial design for decades to emphasize intended use and enhance the user experience. At the same time, Danes appreciate simplicity and functionality. There are many examples. I'm just going to mention one, which you all know, Lego. Lego is perhaps the most well-known example of this. The Lego brick, in its present form, was launched in 1958. And the Lego brick, it hasn't changed ever since. It is simple, and at the same time, it's very, very complex. The interlocking principle makes it unique and offers unlimited, really unlimited, building possibilities. I enjoy that myself, now and then with my grandchildren. At the same time, Lego has a strong focus on the environment. It was announced recently, some of you might have heard that, that a range of bricks will now be launched, and they will be made from a plastic based on sugarcane. Now, what is why is it that this strong combination of innovation, sustainability, and design has evolved in Denmark? What is the reason? Well, I think the main reason is that we are a small, open economy. Our population is about the same size as the population of the voivodeship of Mazowiecki. So our domestic market is very, very small. So in order for Danish companies to survive, they need to be competitive, not only in Denmark, because the market is simply too tiny. They need to be competitive in the global marketplace, otherwise they will die. Now, how can we share this creativity and innovativeness with Poland? Well, the good news is that this is happening already as I speak. There are about 500 Danish companies in Poland employing about 50,000 employees. most of these companies are global innovative leaders in their industries. At the same time, they are well integrated in Poland, they have a local supply chain, and they draw on the strong competitive advantages that Poland has due to its well-qualified labor force, its creativity, and the strong tradition in engineering and science. And just to mention one example, the Danish window producer Velux employs about 3,500 people at four high-tech manufacturing facilities in Poland. The products are not only innovative, they are also designed to be green, energy efficient, and environmentally friendly. Production is based on wood from Poland's forest, and the main factory in Gniezno is heated by wooden chips. I think this is a very good example of sustainable design in an innovation-driven business. And I'm happy that you have invited Velux to be part of the panel later on today on designing ecological innovations. Another example is architecture. On Friday, a representative of the Danish Polish pioneer in designing ecological urban spaces and public buildings, Bjerg Architecture Polska, will be on a panel on urban space design. The company was founded in Denmark 30 years ago, but now it's deeply rooted in Poland. Their architects are Polish, and they have a strong record with projects throughout Poland sharing the same characteristics. They're sustainable and technically state of the art, while respecting the history and legacy of the surrounding area. Thus, there is an excellent basis for a strengthened partnership, not least because there's a strong and robust entrepreneurial spirit in Poland that is very, very conducive to innovation and creativity. Now, this potential for a Polish partnership with your northern neighbors have been noted already. Last year, the Scandinavian Polish Chamber of Commerce published a report on innovative solutions of Scandinavian companies in Poland with many very good concrete examples. The Undersecretary of State in the Ministry of Development at that time, Ms. Jadwiga Emilewicz, who is now the Minister for Technology and Entrepreneurship, wrote the following in the preface to the publication. Scandinavia is a valuable resource of inspiration for us when it comes to developing innovative solutions. It's therefore worth taking advantage of the Scandinavian experience and develop Polish-Scandinavian cooperation in this field further. I couldn't agree more. The time is right, and I think, and let me assure you, we are ready, and I hope that this conference can be a step in that direction. Let me conclude by extending my warmest congratulations to the Polish Patent Office on the 100 years of the system of industrial property protection. Continue the excellent work that you're doing, and I look forward to working with you. Thank you very much for your attention. I wish you a very productive conference.